Hello, I'm Barry Nerhus, and we're standing in Belize looking over a mangrove swamp. Mangrove swamps only occur in the tropics around the world in estuaries and salt marshes. This one is actually on an island called Ambergris Cay. The vegetation behind us that you see is actually the mangrove. There are several species of mangrove trees or shrubs that occur in this mangrove system. Now, the top canopy layer, which is the greenery that you see in the background, is the actual canopy. So that's where you'll have nesting birds, you'll have insects and pollinators, and where they also produce seeds. So animals that eat these seeds will also be living in these areas. Then in the lower part of the that you see that branching that kind of enters the water, that's an important area that creates mudflats. And what happens is the mangroves sequester carbon and they start building up sediment with all the bacteria and things that are in there. So these roots actually that are extended in this wetland are the reason for these stilts is they need to breathe. The soils don't have any oxygen in them. Most wetland soils are anoxic or no oxygen. So the way that this plant has adapted for that is it makes these stilts which have a bunch of pores on them that allows them to actually exhale. So this is the way they breathe. And we could take a look right down here towards the roots, and you can see the tiny little dots on the root structures. Those are the lenticels. Those lenticels are actually what allow the mangrove plant to actually exhale oxygen as it goes through its cellular respiration. So plants still go through the cellular respiration, even though the leaves are doing photosynthesis. So the mangrove forest is one of the top carbon sequesterers in the world, which means it pulls in a lot of carbon. It just sucks it in with a straw, essentially, and just... And as it sucks it in, it builds up the soil. So it pulls the carbon in, and then it goes into the soil as in leaves and decomposition. But since it's anoxic, no oxygen, the leaves then decompose at a slower rate. Thus, this organic layer in the water then builds and builds and builds and builds, and you actually can start getting an island or a barrier island. And these islands can protect our coast where most people live from storms, floods, hurricanes, things like that. So these also provide a service, a physical barrier service. So the mangrove forest has a multitude of structures that you can see, where you see the top green layer, which actually is called the canopy. Then you can also see that middle layer, which is the root system, which creates another type of habitat. And then underwater is actually another system. So the top layer is where birds nest, where bees pollinate, and where you can get flowers and seeds and things like that. And then that's also where you get the carbon to where it's being sequestered that's building the whole system. Then in the roots, it may look like a little jail cell, but some of these birds really enjoy these areas where they can hide, like rails and mudflat living birds, and they'll nest on the ground. And then underneath, these roots continue to go underneath, and then you have the fisheries. So the fisheries are where everything's hiding. There are small crocodiles in here and things where these small fish are going to be hiding. So it's really, really important to have this system in a full menagerie of life that you see so much. Even though we don't see much happening right now, there's a whole bunch of things happening right in front of us. Okay, so the mangroves serve many services. They have a lot of ecological services, and we're going to talk about three today. So the first one will be fisheries, and the second is coastal protection, and the third one is aesthetics. So, number one, fisheries. As I was explaining, is the roots actually are an area where fish can actually harbor and hide and lay eggs and produce a lot of young. So large populations and a huge diversity of fish in here. So why is that important to humans? Well, most people live on the coast, and a great number of people on this planet need fisheries to survive for food and for jobs. And so there's a major economy that actually exists because of the fisheries. Number two, so coastal protection. So mangroves have this whole structure, you can see it, almost like walls of trees that you see. and they create these islands like this one we're standing on. And so what happens is protects the coast, because when big storms in the tropics come, out of usually tropical depression storms or hurricanes, these actually can protect from through wave action and mitigate the impact of the waves before it actually hits the shore. So it breaks up that energy. And these mangroves have adapted for these storms so that they can break apart and then actually regrow again. So another basic service that a mangrove swamp can give to us is recreation. You can see we have the beauty that actually attracts us to these areas for vacation or kayaking, bird watching. There are a lot of different things that just attract us to a beautiful area like this. The silence, just the sounds of nature that we hear. So there are many important services that this mangrove swamp gives us that's more than just scientific ecological services, but also things that allow us to relax as a people. Okay, so mangroves, we know that how they exist. They have certain services, they have a certain productivity level. But let's talk about something that we all need to be aware of, and it's a growing danger, is climate change. So climate change is where we are having more and more carbon released into the atmosphere through fossil fuels, through natural processes. But these fossil fuels are increasing the rate of climate change at an unsustainable rate that we haven't seen for over 600,000 years. And so with that, we are starting to receive a sea level rise increasing that we can see in a matter of decades. Glaciers around the world are melting. And here, these mangroves are barely above sea level. They're right at sea level, essentially, because this is a tidal marsh. And as sea level rises, these mangroves are going to have to find a way to actually migrate out into a higher elevation. So the importance of mangroves, though, is that they actually can sequester carbon at an extreme rate. This is the tropics. It has the greatest level of solar energy or insulation on the planet, with ultimately always having water resources. So this, what is called carbon sequestration, through photosynthesis, this plant life and algae and things in this system are sequestering or grabbing that carbon and then building their bodies, and which things feed on, and it keeps a whole food web alive through a carbon cycle. And so these plants are critical in helping with the balance of our carbon cycle on the planet. The problem is we've lost 50% or more of these mangrove swamps around the world. A lot of them are due to urban development, fish farming, and then pollution. So we've lost over 50% of our mangrove swamps around the world, which is an immense amount of area. Luckily here in Belize, they've managed to preserve and conserve roughly 96% of their mangroves throughout this modernization of our planet. So hopefully they can continue to protect this valuable ecosystem before it's too late for climate change.